Watch this video for the top 10 questions to ask your solar salesperson for a smooth and successful solar installation. I'm Larry.
And I'm Warren. And for over 15 years, Paradise Energy has helped thousands of people control their energy costs and save money with solar energy.
And it's this invaluable experience that we use to bring you an honest inside look at all things solar energy. Let's get into the questions. So Warren, what's the first question that someone that's interested in solar should ask their solar consultant?
Yeah, you know, one of the biggest questions or most important ones is how long has the company been in business? You know, Larry, the solar industry has had its ups and its downs and its challenges, and they call it the solar coaster for a reason. And we've seen, the unfortunate reality is that we've seen businesses come in and out of the industry far more frequently than we'd like to see. And so you want to make sure that the company you're working with is making sound decisions that allows them to navigate those challenging times so that they're going to be around in 10, 15, 20, 30, 40 years to support those warranty claims.
Yeah, this is really a big one.
Yeah.
There's a lot of complexity in the solar industry. There's complexity around incentives. There's complexity around things utilities are doing. So not only is it, you know, will the company actually be around?
Yeah.
But do they know how to navigate those really challenging situations to make a successful install? So certainly a big one. Every company has to start somewhere.
Right.
But it's still to know that your company's been around for at least 5, 10, 15 plus years is super helpful.
Yeah. It lends to the experience as well. How long have you and your team had experience installing solar?
Mm-hmm. Right. Right. Cool. So what's the next question?
Yeah. On how trained are the employees, the installers, the designers? Is everybody trained and certified in their specific line of work? You know, there's industry certifications in solar that really go in depth in training folks within their specific line of work. And it's important that you look for a company that trains their employees, finds value in training their employees, as well as helping the employees improve their own professional development by getting certified.
Yeah, absolutely. And this kind of ties back into the first question.
Yeah.
The longer you've been around, the more experience you have. But it goes even beyond that. There's a couple of certifications that we feel are very important here at Paradise Energy. One is the NABCEP certification.
Yeah.
It's a recognized nationally. Another one is we do a lot of courses through Solar Energy International, and there's some certification programs there that we feel are very important. Now, I will say there's other training platforms and certifications out there. These aren't the only ones, but these are two of the ones to be aware of that we feel are important.
Absolutely.
So what's the next question?
The next question that's probably almost as important as the first two is what do the customers say about you? What do your reviews look like? Ask the company whether or not you could talk to some existing customers and find out what their experience was dealing with that company. Go on Google, go on Facebook and look at reviews and find out what their customers are saying about the experience of working with that company.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. And one of the things I like to look for when I'm buying something is, you know, have their reviews improved over time?
Yeah.
You know, what do their reviews look like today? But what about 3 years ago? What are their older customers saying, you know, from a longer time ago? But then also, what's the more recent? So to kind of get a multi-year perspective there, Google reviews can help out with that. You know, video testimonials, those types of things. Good. That's excellent.
And references. Feel free to ask them if you can talk to some of their customers.
Yep. That's very powerful. What's the fourth question?
I would say the next question is most people want to know how long is it going to take to get my solar installation installed? I'm signing a contract with you today. Are you going to be on site next week doing the installation? Is it going to happen this year? What does that time frame look like, and what's involved, and what's my involvement as the buyer?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that can be a difficult one to answer.
Yeah.
Because at least for us right now, we have a long backlog of projects.
Sure.
So we might not get to the project as quickly as we could have otherwise. And then beyond that, you know, will it take 3 days to install? Will it take 3 weeks? A reputable solar installer should be able to tell you, hey, I think we can get to your project in 3 months, and it's, you know, it should take us about 3 days to install. They should know with a high level of certainty. Now, one caveat there to the development time of these projects is how long will it take the utility to give approval?
And I think it's safe to say that, Larry, residential projects move much quicker,
yep.
and commercial projects usually take a little longer, more complexity in the design as well as the permitting phase.
Absolutely. Residential, generally not an issue, but commercial projects can be kind of hit and miss with some utilities.
Yep.
Again, your installer should have experience with those utilities and should be able to help guide you through that. So what's the next question, Warren? What's number five?
When you get a system installed, there's a lot of paperwork. There could be grants, there's applications for permits, interconnection with the utility. So one of the questions we get asked is, who's going to handle all of the paperwork? Who's going to write the grants? And that's something you need to know, what your level of involvement is going to be in terms of applying for these permits or writing grants.
Absolutely, yeah. And it's not wrong to have the customer do the permit application or do some of the grant applications. But you want to know ahead of time, and you want to make sure that you're comfortable with that. Generally speaking, we do all of that for our customers because we get really good at it.
Yeah.
But some customers may want to do that. But you just want to make sure you're clear ahead of time. What's the next one? What's number six?
And one last point on that is that some companies will include that as a value-added services, and some companies will charge you for those additional services. So just be aware of that.
Ah, excellent point. You want to make sure it's in your contract. You know what's happening, who's doing what.
The next question we get asked is, where does your equipment come from and what equipment do you use? There's some people who are concerned, customers who are concerned on where the product originated from for multiple reasons. Some of the new domestic content requirements are part of the IRA bill can help customers get an additional tax credit if it's made and originates from the United States. And they're also concerned about the quality of the products that we're using.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is a big one because you've got warranties on products that are 10, 20, sometimes 25 years or longer, and you want to make sure the company's reputable.
Yeah.
And you also want to make sure that it's made somewhere where you're okay with. And the challenge here is that historically, China has manufactured a lot of the solar products for the world. Now that's starting to change. We're starting to see some more domestic manufacturing, which is exciting, and something that we're talking about in our videos, and hopefully we'll see more of that.
Yeah, absolutely. And then, you know, another question we get, Larry, is what type of financing do you offer? And this is a tricky one because we don't offer any in-house financing here at Paradise Energy Solutions. We do have partnerships with some companies that can help out with financing, both on the residential, the commercial, and the nonprofit side of things. But by and large, you're better off getting your own financing through your own bank or credit union. You'll do much better than some of these other financing options. That may not be true for nonprofits. There's some really specific financing instruments for nonprofits that work really well, given the new incentives for nonprofits. So that may be unique. But by and large, customers will do better off getting their own financing elsewhere as opposed to financing through some of the partners that we work with.
Right, right. And one thing that I would encourage you to do when you're talking to your solar company and you're asking about financing solutions is ask for a cash option as well, because you might be surprised how much of a dealer fee is building on your upfront cost to pay or to buy down the interest rate on some of that financing. It might look great, 4.99%, whatever the percentage might be, but there might be an added cost up front, so make sure you check that out before you just run with the financing that's offered to you and compare it to your local bank.
Yes.
Make sure you do a comparison there.
And obviously make sure that your return on investment is higher than the interest rate that you're paying on the loan.
Absolutely, yep. Yeah. Very important. So yep. What's number eight, Warren? What's the next one?
You know, how do you plan to service and support my solar array in years to come, 5, 10, 20 years down the line? Who's going to maintain it and what maintenance is really involved in that? That's an important question because, you know, solar is a long-term investment. And these systems are designed to last 25, 30, 40 years, maybe more. And you want to make sure that you're getting all of the energy that's been promised to you out of those systems. And they do require some maintenance and support. And we have other videos on the maintenance and support piece. But from the homeowner's perspective or the business owner's perspective, they really want to make sure that their solar array remains free from shade or obstacles and that they continue to put or have reliable internet available. But other than that, the diagnosing of issues and coming out and doing warranty work, all of that is done by the installer. And so you want to make sure that, again, you're picking a reputable company that's going to be around, going back to the very first question, in 20 years from now, who's going to be able to support those systems.
Yep, definitely, definitely. And another question to ask along with that is to say, how long have you been doing service work on solar projects?
Yeah.
Newer companies might not know what all it takes to service your inverter, to service your equipment, especially for larger commercial projects. Work with a company that has a dedicated service department. That's one of the things that we wrestled with in the early days of our service department was we need dedicated personnel who know the ropes of these different inverter manufacturers and can service them and do the work well. So that's another important question to ask kind of along with that.
Yeah. And this question is really a great segue into the next question that we get asked, Larry. And that is, what type of warranties do you offer? It's a great question to ask. And we really break that down into two separate categories of warranties. There's the warranties that come with the hardware. So your solar panel comes with its own warranty, usually 25 years or so in that range, and it has production warranties along with it. Your inverters will have similar manufacturer warranties. But then in addition to the product, the hardware warranties, there are the warranties from the company that installed it, usually a workmanship warranty, maybe a production guarantee, maybe some monitoring along with that as well. That's really important to know that you're getting both the hardware covered as well as the workmanship, and then diagnosing problems if something comes up is all going to be taken care of by the company that you choose.
And I think that is a hidden thing in some contracts is the diagnosing piece.
Yeah.
So one of the things to understand is that a module or an inverter manufacturer won't honor their warranty unless they have the data that they need to prove that there's an issue. And so who's doing that troubleshooting? Who's going out on site if need be or looking at the monitoring portal, determining there's an issue and then getting in contact with the manufacturer? So who is doing that in the warranty? Is that the installer? Are you going to have to pay extra for that? That's something to understand. And of course, the production guarantee, I mean, that simply guarantees the production that you're going to get. So that's about as rock solid as you can get. What affects the production? You know, does the company allow for weather? You know, sure. If there's weather variation, are they off the hook? I've seen some warranties where companies can get off the hook for just about anything. So make sure you read the fine details there of the warranty.
And the last question we get, Larry, is how can you be sure that the company you're selecting is financially stable? Again, back to number one, are they going to be around in years to come to support your system? And the unfortunate reality is that most solar companies are private and their financials are private as well. Mm-hmm. But don't be afraid to ask them if they're profitable, how long they've been around, and get your own comfort level with their profitability or sustainability. The unfortunate reality is most of the public companies who you do have access to their financials have awful financials. They have great investors, but not great financials. So look for a company that's been around for a while that you feel confident is going to be able to support your system in years to come, because it's a long-term investment and that's extremely important.
Yeah, and I think a couple of questions, like you mentioned, you know, one question you can ask is, are you profitable?
Yeah.
And one of the things that we can say here at Paradise is, yes, we have been profitable every year of our existence, 15 years, which is remarkable in the solar coaster.
Yes.
And you might have a solar installer that is not profitable for a year and then profitable most other years. That can be okay because the solar industry does go up and down. But I think what you're looking for, if possible, is profitability every year. The other thing to think about is if they do have warranties, one question to ask is, are they setting aside monies to service those warranties? If they have a 10-year warranty and they're not setting aside money to service that warranty for 10 years, then they could find themselves in the financial pickle in 2, 4, 6, 8 years from now.
If you're a business leader or homeowner and want to see how solar can help you save more of your hard-earned money, visit ParadiseEnergy.com to request your free custom quote. In addition, our website is full of calculators, blogs, buyer's guides, and more, all designed to help you on your way to a successful solar investment. Thanks for watching, and click here to watch the next video.